It's official. According to a recent Gallup survey, 48% of Americans support a universal basic income. As recently as a decade ago, this kind of proposal would have been unthinkable. Well, almost. Welcome to Wait Till You Hear This. I'm Steve Eastman. First of all, there are a number of ways a universal basic income, or UBI proposal, could be implemented. Quoting from the Gallup write-up, we learned one way. Under a UBI program, the federal government would provide every adult below a certain income threshold with a specific amount of money each year. But that's not the only way. A two-year, limited UBI proposal in the UK would pay everyone under the age of 55 the equivalent of $14,000 annually. And other governments either have been or will be testing their own versions of universal basic income. Remember I said a UBI plan was almost unthinkable a decade ago? Well, two Belgian academics did make such a proposal back then, but basic income, a radical proposal for a free society and a sane economy, was not widely accepted. Philip Van Parijs and Yannick Vandervoort have recently revised and updated their proposal. So why the new interest in universal basic income? The promoters of UBI generally say we need it to combat predicted job loss attributed to artificial intelligence or AI systems. As with most politically correct proposals, I suspect there's an ulterior motive. Now, how about a demographic breakdown on who supports universal basic income? According to Gallup, the younger a voting age citizen is, the more likely he or she loves it. Senior citizens are the most resistant. Also, those without a college degree are more likely to support UBI than their better educated peers. Of the supporters, 54% say they would be unwilling to pay higher taxes to subsidize the cost. It seems they'd much rather shift the expense to companies benefiting from artificial intelligence. Ready for a dose of reality? For the last century, a major purpose of public opinion polls has been to drive changes in society that were unthinkable only a short time earlier. And consider this. The education system is failing to give us the background we need to evaluate the latest politically correct proposal. Many citizens do not recognize from history that redistribution of income is an unsustainable system. Take Russia and China, for example. They've been forced to embrace a measure of capitalism. And it looks like Cuba is heading in that direction as well. You may not know this, but I've worked with the homeless for several years. I can tell you some want to get a job and be productive members of society, and there are others content to live on handouts as long as they continue. I believe universal basic income would promote laziness at the expense of more entrepreneurial citizens. Look at it this way. States requiring able-bodied welfare recipients to work see more people getting jobs. There are two other issues to consider. Number one, the U.S. Constitution does not give Congress authority to institute anything faintly resembling universal basic income. Yes, I know the term welfare appears in the document twice, but today's meeting was clearly not the original intent of the Founding Fathers. It wasn't until the 20th century that someone co-opted the term welfare to promote a type of socialism. Now, here's where I get more extreme. I believe charity should be the business of nonprofits, which people could better support without so many expensive government programs siphoning off their money. Okay, ready for issue number two? Nothing from the government is free. That's even true when Washington gives money to the states. There are always strings attached. For example, if a state decided to lower the drinking age to 18, it would lose federal highway funds. I suspect a future universal basic income requirement would pressure people to be politically correct, or else. But now the emphasis is on getting UBI's foot in the door. This is Steve Eastman for Wait Till You Hear This.
Discover more stories like this one on our website, waittillyouhearthis.com.